The Black Lives Matter protests had started with a cause, but today they have been hijacked by enemies of the United States. The most dangerous of them being radical Islamists, from Al-Qaeda to Iran, all are fueling the civil unrest in the US to win their own battles. George Floyd's custodial killing has become the biggest political tool in recent memory. Every single nefarious element has targeted the United States of America over George Floyd's death. Not just leftists, but radical Islamists of the world, from the Islamist regime of Iran to the terror organization Al-Qaeda, all have tried to whitewash their own racial prejudices and capitalize on the civil unrest gripping the US. Basically, some of the biggest racists in the world are now targeting the US over allegations of anti-black racism, and their agenda is not to achieve a fair and liberal society. Their agenda is to do their very best to worsen the civil unrest in the US. When Black Lives Matter protests took grip of the US for the first time, leftist radicals and Antifa took over the protests, turned them violent, and tried to normalize lootings, arson, and vandalism in a number of US cities. Violent protests have surfaced again in the US. The fresh excuse is the deployment of federal agents by US President Donald Trump in Portland, Oregon's biggest city. Political detractors like the Portland mayor, Ted Wheeler, have also involved themselves deeply with the fresh spate of violence. Wheeler himself got tear gassed when he turned up at the site of the protest. Trump has slammed Wheeler for participating in the violent protests. Taking a dig at Wheeler, the US president said that the Portland mayor looked pretty pathetic for attending a rally and made a fool out of himself. Trump added that he wanted to be among the people, so he went into the crowd. And so they knocked the hell out of him. So that was the end of him. Amidst all this, radical Islamists have found the best opportunity to achieve their long-held dreams of destroying the US. Over the past 2 months, Islamists have almost taken over the Black Lives Matter protests. The latest issue of the jihadist outfit Al-Qaeda's online magazine, One Ummah, for instance, exploited the iconic image of the twilight of George Floyd's life. Armed protests rage across America and a civil war appears to be in the offing. Al-Qaeda wants to lead the nationwide US protests and further says, "Not even the Democrats can help you, but we can." Al-Qaeda released a letter which applauds protesters and rioters for rising up against racists and the arrogant White House. Al-Qaeda also encourages them to establish justice with their own hands. But there's a catch. Al-Qaeda offers Islam as the cure for America. They say that it is the religion which ensures that people live in freedom, dignity, and peace, and doesn't allow discrimination of any sort between white or black. Yes, Al-Qaeda, one of the most dreaded and genocidal terror organizations in the world, is making a rosy offer to the people of the US. Al-Qaeda is not alone. Even Iran, a Shia-majority country that has emerged as the hotbed of anti-Semitism, wants to make maximum political use of the Black Lives Matter protests. Iran itself wants to wipe the Jewish homeland from the face of the earth, but has no qualms against shaming the US over George Floyd's death. Iran has been hosting George Floyd vigils, and their lawmakers have been calling for the death of their biggest enemy, you know who. The Shia majority republic has even depicted the late George Floyd as a Shia Muslim martyr. The Turkish government has joined the bandwagon too. The wannabe Khalifa and the self-acclaimed representative of the world's Muslims, the Turkish president has also come down heavily on what he calls the racist and fascist approach that led to the death of George Floyd in the US city of Minneapolis as a result of torture. Erdogan also said that he will be monitoring the issue. Yes, Erdogan, the man whose jihadist mercenaries have committed some of the most ghastly war crimes in Libya and against the Kurdish people in northeast Syria, wants to monitor the issue of American racism. Within Turkey, Erdogan wants to revive the Ottoman Empire that had killed and expelled 1.5 million Armenians. Erdogan is facing backlash around the world for converting the Hagia Sophia Cathedral into a mosque again, and therefore he feels there can be no better opportunity to divert attention than the Black Lives Matter protests. This is not it. AJ Castrada writes in his article for the Jewish News Syndicate, Palestinian activists throughout the United States and abroad tried to turn the subsequent protests against police brutality into an American intifada, and Floyd himself into a shaheed. He also added that some protesters in American cities have displayed Palestinian flags. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. On June 12, Gaza's Islamic scholar Dr. Tahir al-Lulu's speech aired on Palestine Today TV. The Islamist radical criticized the racial discrimination imposed by Trump and the whites. Ironically, anti-American Islamists giving sermons against racism couldn't hide their joy at visuals of arson in the US. Al-Lulu said, "For 10 days, America has been engulfed in flames. We pray to Allah that these flames will burn the sons of Zion, America." George Floyd died a painful death which no one deserves to die. But the events post his death are just as disturbing.